Hey guys.
Hello.
All right, go for Travis.
Travis, just what's your approach to playoffs this year with everything that has been going on this season?
Excited, man. Excited to get out there. I know we got a big challenge with Miami coming in, and sure enough, who doesn't love playoff football at Arrowhead, baby?
Growing a playoff beard out?
I've been growing this thing out for a while now. see how far I can take it, man.
Charles, what did resting last week do for you?
Say it again?
What did resting last week do for you?
I just feel like, especially it being a short week, being able to get out here and put some good work in with the guys. And I felt like we, as a collective unit, we came in and put in a great week of work.
I wonder if you could take us back through the conversation to not play last week. Coach said it was up to you, really, to try to get those 16 yards or whatever.
At the end of the day, I just didn't care enough about it. I felt like I could get some rest and let the guys go out there and just play the game instead of worrying about getting this old guy 16 yards, man. It just never felt right, man.
You have talked for several years now about legacy and stuff like that. You're talking more about team legacy, Super Bowls, than legacy like a thousand.
Yeah, those, yeah, I mean, I think without a doubt, I'm thinking more Super Bowls when I talk legacy, and just having that desire to be a certain type of teammate day in, day out, and having channeling that right mindset for sure.
Travis, when you played Miami and Germany, what can you take from that game? How different are these two teams as they battle for a
spot? Well, first thing is that they have a really good secondary. I think that's one of their best secondaries in the league. That being said, Fangio's got them playing very good as a collective unit. They fly around, they play physical football. And with that being said, we got to be able to control the line of scrimmage and make third downs a lot easier with good plays and good movement on first and second.
Travis, I know this isn't in front of your mind now, but a month and a half ago you had an interview where you mentioned that you think about retirement. Just wondering if you've
Do you guys think about retirement? Am I the only one in this boat?
No.
Is anybody else in this thing? All right, whoever's not thinking about stuff down the road, you know, I blame you. I think it's just I have no reason to stop playing football, man. I love it. We still have success. Come in with the right mindset, and I just love the challenge that it gives me every single day to try and be at my best. And like I said, I have no desire to stop anytime soon.
If you said you thought about it, what would you do if you weren't playing football?
That's the point. The off season, you know, being able to get out there and really find what you love to do. And I've been fortunate to do a few things outside of the sports world that I've been enjoying doing, like getting on camera. The SNL stuff kind of opened up a new happiness and a new maybe a new career path for me, but. It's funny for me to even say that at this point in my career because I think it's so much further down the road than it is right now.
Travis, when you get a break like you did last week, you have had so much attention from all the defenses. They play you physical. They try to disrupt everything. You're the main guy. Did you get any perspective on maybe a way to, I don't know, handle that kind of attention or what you can do to kind of somehow, you know, kind of free up a little bit?
Yeah, there's still ways to impact the game, and that's in the run game being able to be a good blocker, in the pass game running my routes accordingly to get other guys open if it's possible. You know, getting a lot of attention, you can free up a lot of guys, and I think that's the biggest thing is you're still finding ways to help out the team, even if they are quote-unquote taking you away. But yeah, love the challenge.
I apologize, Travis. In your 11 years in the league now, between the hyperactivity in week one and just the little nicks and dings that go throughout the year and the challenges with the offense, has this been the most challenging year for you maybe?
Man, I would have to go down the list of year by year, but I've enjoyed the challenge of this year. Obviously, not the same success, but it's a different journey, and you just got to appreciate every journey as they come along, man.
What about this challenge have you?
It's like I said, it's just new. It's new. It's a new feel. It's a new challenge to, you know, find ways to get open. It's a new challenge to find ways to get wins. I think I went up to Amenahu after one game or during one game and said, man, we just got to become a team that just grinds these games out, man. It's not the same NFL as it was for us a few years ago. And for whatever reason, you know, when it comes down to third, fourth quarter, we just got to be able to grind it out as a team. And I think everybody understands that.
At what point have y'all understood that, you know, the points just are not going to come as much as like they used to?
You know, I think you're always at trying to challenge yourself to have that, you know, to get back to that success, because those are the expectations you set for yourself, right? So it's not just accepting it. It's still trying to get to those goals, but at the same time, understand situational football towards the end of games and be there when your team needs you the most.
What's the key to locking in on the playoffs? I mean, you feel a difference in the air right now.
At this point in the year, you just know you got a special team. You know, you've gone through the ups and downs of the season. You find yourself sitting in the playoffs, and anything can happen in the dance.
Couple more.
Yeah, so much playoff experience yourself, and even your young guys have a lot of playoff experience because you won the Super Bowl last year. How important is that, and can you maybe remember what it was like your very first playoff game? There wasn't a lot of people on this team who had had playoff experience at that point.
I mean, it's just going to be really fast. It is what it is. The playoffs are that much faster, and it kind of gradually goes up steps as you go along in the playoffs, and you got to practice that much harder. You know, it's not necessarily that you're practicing harder; you're just practicing with that much more focus on the little things, and it's because, you know, things happen faster in the playoffs, and it's it can be overwhelming, but at the same time, I think that's why you got good leaders, guys that have been there, and we've been fortunate to have those guys.
And experience is valuable, though.
Oh, yeah. I mean, guys are just flying around. They don't know what they don't know, baby.
We'll close it out with Adam and then Nate.
Travis, you talked a minute ago about how this has been a different kind of journey for you guys, mm-hmm. trying to find different ways to get the job done. Has that had an effect on Pat, you think, one way or the other?
I mean, we're all growing in this thing together. It is, you know, I think Coach Reed, even over the course of his career, he's had some ups and downs, but understands, you know, what it takes to get there. And so you latch onto those leaders and you take advice when you can and just roll with the punches, because we all are still kind of learning in this thing together. Every single season is going to be different, and you got to accept it.
And Travis, I know you obviously had a moment with Tyreek after the game in Germany. Just how much have you thought about having time during Saturday's game to watch what he's like to perform in Arrowhead for the first time as an opponent?
You know what? I expect KC to give him nothing but love until he's putting up the peace sign or something like that. Then he might hear a few boos, but who he was for this community it speaks volumes. You know, every single kid's camp he had, he made it his effort to go out and shake those hands and give those kids an experience they'll never have again. And, you know, that's why Tyreek is loved in this city. And he'll forever be loved in this city because of who he was off the field in this community as well, man. So it's going to be electric just to see him, man. He's always one of the best football players in the league when he's on the field. So.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Have a good one, guys.